We've documented it for National Heritage. So it's the 21st vehicle on the National Historic Vehicle Register. That's a program with Department of Interior and Library of Congress. All this documentation about what this car looks like today and where it is today, it will all be kept in perpetuity for the American people. And that's what we're all about. We're all about sharing this wonderful story of probably one of the most iconic automobiles in the history of, you know, in American history. So this is a true national treasure, and it deserves to be here. It deserves to be here in front of the Ford stand, along with the new, along with the 2019 Bullitt Mustang. It's just a great tribute to Sean's family, to the McQueens, to its entire history, and the history of filmmaking, which, you know, this was the first of the Furious.
How you doing? So, Mikhail, the question comes. It was 6,000 in road and track.
Yep.
What is it today?
Well, it's funny. It's not, you know, the story isn't even 24 hours old, and I keep being asked the same question.
The same question.
It's a, it, you know,
because
with,
it's an antique roadshow, right?
Yeah, it's antique roadshow, yeah. Yes. I'm like the guy that comes in and says, this is what your vase and your and your attic was is worth. You know, it's tough with movie cars, with television cars, because they're kind of, they're both just a car. And this car is a car that's well-worn, and in fact, because it was a movie car, it has a lot of modifications they made to do the filming with. Movie cars in this era were pretty butchered to make them work. But again, this is the McQueen car. This is the car that was in the chase in San Francisco.
That's the proof in the pudding.
Look That's for the all proof. The, yeah, you look for all those little, you know, witness marks, all those little things that go with making it a movie car and that make it the car.
Right.
And so then you do, okay, so where do you start valuing something like this? It's not, you don't compare it to a normal Mustang. You know, to me, there are only a couple of examples of movie cars that have sold for, you know, recently, the original Batmobile, the James Bond DB5, the original DB5 actually disappeared some years ago. So this was the second car. And that car sold for almost $5 million. The Batmobile sold for 4 point something. And so, you know, if somebody
said... You're seeing a range here.
Yeah, you kind of see a range. I mean, if somebody said, you know, 3 to 5 million, you wouldn't be surprised at all. I don't think the owner has any plans to sell it, but, you know, now that it's public, I'm sure an awful lot of people will try to get it because Steve McQueen was the king of cool. And all of his cars have been, you know, they're well known, they're highly documented typically, and highly sought after because he was just, he was kind of, for people who love cars, Steve McQueen was our celebrity.
Right.
Because he
and for
really
women
drove.
Who loved guys, Steve McQueen was our
yeah, yeah, yeah. Well, yeah. There was all of that too,
yeah,
right?
You know, the men loved him. The women loved him.
No, yeah. He had all of that stuff.
Yes.
And but he also was a real driver, and he really collected cars when he wasn't on camera.
Right.
I mean, he had some wonderful cars that he owned in it, you know, in his private life,
right.
And he really wanted this one back, but he never got it back, and so that's what makes this story so special.
So, what did Sean say? Was he sitting down when you told him?
Well, yeah, I had to, well, first of all, we had to get the car insured for him, and I sort of warned him. I said, you know, there's no easy way to set this value, but to set a value in that range is, you know, very substantiable, and we were very comfortable going that direction. But, you know, frankly, I'd hate to ever see this car go up to auction. Because you know there'd just be a feeding frenzy for people trying to get it.
I could imagine that Bill Ford would be in that frenzy.
Lots of people would, I imagine, yes.
You know, the one thing that I'm kind of sad about is Denise McLuggage is gone.
Yeah.
And she was such a lovely journalist, such a lovely race car driver, but she also dated Steve McQueen.
Oh, and she had a spectacular life.
Yes,
and
she did.
At time, a different interview, but yeah, she
but
probably
she would have loved to have seen this car.
Oh, she would. She would have patted the fender differently.